Good morning, family. Pastor Artie here with your manna and coffee. Yeah, it's a good one. Oh my goodness, that tastes so good in the morning. Hey, you know, I'm out here in the garden. I just got done watering because it's going to be really hot here in Corona. It's supposed to be 115 today. You'd almost think I was living in Arizona in Phoenix. Man, it's warm. You know, but you know, it tells us in Galatians 5:1, it says, "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free, and be not entangled again in the yoke of bondage." You know, when I used to live in a property that had a lot of trees, you know, they also had a lot of spiders. And these spiders would spin their webs all through the tree branches and stuff. And I'd go out there and try to enjoy my coffee in the morning. And, you know, you get wrapped up in those spider webs. And, man, you start doing the spider web dance. You know, those of you who never walked into a spider web, you don't know what the spider web dance is. But let me tell you, it is not fun. It freaks you out. But, you know, I was thinking about that this morning when God gave me this scripture. You know, we have to stand firm in the liberty that Christ has given us. You know, to stand firm means to plant our feet as though they're in concrete and stand fast, not being moved, to be immovable. That's what that word means, to stand fast, is immovable. You don't want to be moved. You know, even though winds and waves could hit you, you know, when you were at the beach and your feet would get buried in the sand and the little shore breaks and stuff, and the waves would hit you and try to knock you over, but because your feet were planted in the sand, it was really hard to knock you over, unless it was a really big wave or you were really tiny. You know, that would be my wife. She's really tiny. So, but to stand fast, to be immovable in the liberty that Christ has given us. You know, now the other part he says, and not to be entangled again. You know, so many times we as Christians, we have a tendency to fall backwards. We do. We take 3 steps forward, 2 steps back. Sounds like a book I read one time. But we're so easily entangled. You know, little things get our attention. We are the most, you know, wishy-washy people out there. You know, we have a little pup next door named Sox, and he's so wishy-washy, he doesn't know what he wants. He just wants to be petted, he just wants to be loved. You know, and he goes nuts. His whole body loses control. You know, and that's how we are. We see things we want. Oh, I just gotta have that. I don't care what it costs, I just gotta have that. And all of a sudden we get ensnarled in the sin of gluttony because we want things. That's what God's talking about. Don't get entangled like when you walk out there and a spider web wraps all around your face. You know, have you ever seen when a fly lands in a spider web? What's the first thing that happens, guys? The first thing that happens is the spider comes out and he wraps and entangles his intended victim in a cocoon of webbing so that they cannot move. And it's only until he has done that that he can then inject the venom in order to kill them. Today, family, let's stand firm upon the Word of God and the liberty that He has given us. If you haven't taken time to read this Word today, if you just sit there and let it gather dust on your shelf, then you're wrong. You're wrong. Wait a minute, let me help you again. As a pastor, you're wrong. You gotta read it. You gotta study it. You need to take time with it. You need to take time with the Lord today. You know, don't just settle on one verse. Read a chapter. You'll be amazed what you learn if you just read. And God will give you even more liberty and freedom in Him because you're going to get more of His Word in your heart. The more you put here, the more you're free here. This world has nothing to hold you down. And the sky is the limit, guys. But remember, Satan's also out there to entangle you again and wrap you up like that little fly. And then, what happens? Death will come because he is only out to steal, kill, and destroy. He wants to steal your freedom. He wants to kill you, and he wants to destroy your family. Don't let him do it, guys. stand firm upon the liberties that Christ has given you today. Linda and I love you. We pray you have a blessed weekend. And you guys just enjoy this weekend and have a great time. I know you had a little respite there in the middle with 4th of July. But now it's back to some normalcy. And from Linda and the rest of my staff, we're praying for you guys. We love you. Stand firm in that liberty that Christ has given you. We love you guys. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye.